Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Might & Magic, the World of Xeen. As per usual, we're just going to jump right on in here. And this actually might be a fairly short episode, depending on how much trouble we bump into with Lord Xeen. So we're going to go ahead and here, enter Castle Xeen. We would not have been able to do that without possessing the QB doll. I don't know what it does to you if you don't have it, but you can't get in. I'm going to take a drink. I just got done streaming for like 2 hours, so I'm a little parched. Okay, so, our goal here is, like, to get, I think, to even open this, there's horrible death traps in here, and we have to disable them by going through two towers. There's also, if I recall correctly, I'm gonna go ahead and hit us with Day of Sorcery. I'm gonna save early, and I'm gonna be saving often in here. Because this place is dangerous. We've got Xeen's guards puttering around, these guys. And as you can see, kind of hard to hit. So how am I gonna take them on? I don't know. I'm thinking. And while I do, we get that obnoxious sound effect. See, I don't know if any of our... Oh, no, Swell can actually hit them. And so can Brunhilda, okay. So that gives me a little hope. Just a little. That I'm not gonna have to cheese through this, because these things start coming at us in numbers before too much longer. They don't really seem to be doing too much damage, though, and Dancing Sword seems to screw them up pretty nicely. So I'm gonna go ahead. I'm gonna wait for them to group up. Oh, damn it, I did not mean to do that. I was gonna have her heal so that didn't happen. Man, that sound effect is going to get annoying. I apologize to you guys. Does he actually have... He does, in fact, have Power Cure. And he can cast it twice, which is all he needs to get her to a fairly healthy amount of hit points. Like, I'm not completely pleased that she's there, though. I think I'm going to give her a little bit more. Just going to top her off. There. That is... more satisfactory to me, and I guess... Oh, not enough spell points for Dancing Sword. It is on the melees. Alright, and I think I'm actually going to pull back. And we're going to rebuff here. Like, this is kind of nerve-wracking. If I recall correctly, these things are worth a crap ton of experience points. I think it's 1,000,000. Oh, 200,000. I know you get 1,000,000 for doing something in here. There are a couple things in this game that give you like 1,000,000 or millions of experience points. And I believe there's another one in here. However, unlike that experience point boost we got for saving Korak, none of them have the angelic chorus of, I don't know, angelicness. These are just like, hey, guess what? Have 1,000,000 experience points. Now get out of my house and put your pants on. Okay. Oh, damn it. Oh, wow, we dropped him like a sack of taters. Yeah, these guys aren't too bad. Now, what these are doing, that room that we walked into where the floor damaged us with some poison, these disable it. That room is full of things that deal energy damage to you in not insignificant amounts. And what destroying these will let us do is basically get through there without having our party just turned into poisoned, fired, cold, damaged, you know, hamburger. It's a good thing, to quote Martha Stewart. Oh wow, guys, you are kind of failboating. Come on, I just need, thank you. I was gonna say, I just need one of you to hit here. Alright, she's back to full health again. Alright, so we've cleared those out, and now it's time to go up the towers, and these are kind of double-edged. The first time, going up is easy. It's getting down that's hard. Because on our way down, these things like basically just fill with those guards. Like, as it stands going up, there's just, you know, a couple of them. Like, I think there will be like two or three in the top part, topmost part. But, like, that's not too crazy. And we're gonna, of course, hit these guys with Dancing Swords. Take them down really easily. Yeah. I thought I remembered three of you guys. Come on, guys. Melees, you're failing. No, I don't want Chunk to cast a spell. So I have enough mana for more Dancing Swords, but I'm gonna save it. Alright, go ahead and destroy this. So another 200,000. We're gonna rest so that I have mana, because, as I mentioned, the way down is going to be a bit rougher. How much food do I have? 33 days. I think that should be enough to clear Lord Xeen's estate here. And what I should also have done is checked experience points, because I was gonna say, I'm sure, you know, we're all sitting at somewhere resembling ready to level up. So what I'm actually probably gonna do is, like, clear these two towers, drop a Lloyd's Beacon, go back to town, well, new castle rather, and level, and then we are going to come back, and I'm going to do some damage. I don't know how much it's gonna help, like, one level in the grand scheme of things, but, you know, every little bit. Alright, go ahead and throw out a Dancing Sword, get combat started the right way here. Just turn these guys into, this is decidedly less fortuitous, so they aren't all grouped up. That actually makes it a little harder. That works, though. Oh, come on, there we go. Beautiful. Go ahead, do this, and now I think we should get, like, a million for having destroyed all of them. Nope, just 200,000. Dang. Oh, that was stupid. I walked down the stairs and I totally forgot to buff. If I can just get Day of Protection up, that will give us at least some combat abilities here. And I actually did it again, although, admittedly, Day of Sorcery is not quite as important. It does net us an armor class boost, but these things seem to hit pretty, like, pretty well regardless either way. So, kind of negligible there. Go ahead. I'm really leery to be blowing his spell points. But you know what? That's what they're there for. Alright. Go ahead and wait for this. Once we get later into the game, Dancing Sword and Implosion will be kind of fallback spells for me. Dancing Sword is really nice. It's just, as you guys can see, pretty damaging on my mana pool. Alright. So I think now we have all those done. So I'm going to actually go ahead and drop a Lloyd's Beacon? No, that's the 250 hit point fountain. I'm gonna set a Lloyd's Beacon because if I recall correctly, Lord Xeen, when he hits you, he just kills you. So, it doesn't really matter. How much money do I have? I've got 12,000. This is not going to be enough gold, but I think there's a bank.
Here are your yearly taxes of 50,000 gold.
Alright. I'll take that. That's acceptable. I wasn't expecting that. Now we can afford to level.
What are you?
Not you. There we go. Oh wow. Two levels across the board. I'm actually surprised by that. I'm not complaining though. And everybody else is between, you know, 300,000 and 800,000 experience points away from, you know, another level. That's acceptable. So I don't think we need to fill our packs. Is there a bank? I think this is the temple, yeah. I don't think there's a bank here, so I'm just actually gonna freaking teleport to Vertigo. Because, you know, why not? We're gonna be, you know, supremely lazy about this. How is our look at that, we got some money sitting in there. 292,065 gold pieces. Because we don't need it. None of our I don't think any of our stuff's broken. Yeah, well, gold leafs and roves are, but who cares about those two? They don't need it. They're just sitting in the back row, like, smoking doobies and doing whatever it is spellcasters do when they have too much free time on their hand because the melees are doing all the work. Ahem. Go ahead and save. All right. Let's kind of poke around, see if there's anything worthwhile in here, at least on this floor. I don't think there is. Yeah, I think we just have to go up. I want to be careful, because you know that there's shit just waiting for you. Alright, so that just takes us back around. So up we go. Okay. They're just having us go all over the place here. We'll know it's the last place because the sky is visible. Okay, right over there, if I recall correctly, is where you fight Lord Xeen. But before we get to Xeen, of course, there's still just a little bit more that wants to stop us, and it's actually not this guy. This guy, if I could hit him, doesn't worry me at all. What worries me is that. That is Xeen's pet, and Xeen's pet is a dick. As you can see, as he drops half my party into unconsciousness right off the bat here. Okay, so I'm gonna... Oh, wow. Rove's gonna die. And Brunhilda has absolutely none of that. Xeen's pet comes around, it's like, rawr, everybody's unconscious. Brunhilda's like, spit, axe to the head. Xeen's pet explodes into Dragon Fetty. I honestly was not expecting that. I was figuring that was gonna be a wipe. I think this is another... I think this is the million experience points right here. Nope, another 200,000. I could have sworn there was a million in there. All right. This is it. We're gonna go ahead and give this to Gold Leaf. Rove, I hardly knew ye, because you're probably gonna get eradicated. Xeen is a dick because he doesn't just kill you, he eradicates you. And the trick to him is getting into melee with him as fast as you can. So what we're actually going to do here, that looks like 3 squares, we're going to teleport directly on top of him. Because as you can see, he just kills you. Xeen does not screw around, he's like, no, you're dead. And you're dead. Rove, I am going to have you, I think... You really cannot do screw all here. I'm going to have him cast Starburst. Yeah, I was gonna say, I think he might be immune to that. And once more, Brunhilda is just like, seriously? Seriously. She just kind of looks at Xeen, stabs him in the scrot, and down he goes. So that wasn't bad at all, actually. I think this actually went better than when I did it in my original Let's Play. I remember actually getting a couple people eradicated there. So we have found the temporal distortion staff of his. And you guys remember we were testifying that mirror or whatever? That's this thing right here, and as soon as I use that, we are going to end the game. So I'm going to go ahead and raise Derpnuts McDeadpants over here. Get up! Quit sleeping. Okay. There. Alright, I'm gonna save again. And we're gonna do this. You have found the sixth mirror. As you approach to claim your prize, Xeen's scepter emits a high-pitched whine similar to the sound of a blade sharpened against a whetstone. The sound is echoed and amplified by the mirror, rising rapidly. Just as you realize that the mirror and the scepter are not compatible, the mirror shatters in a spectacular display of light, noise, and violence. The castle gives an awful shudder, groaning as though it were a beast wounded mortally. With masonry falling from the ceiling and dust filling the air, you all decide to remain calm and proceed to the nearest exit in an orderly fashion.
You have defeated my general, Lord Xeen, and foiled my plans to conquer this world, but the dark side shall always be mine.
Congratulations, adventurers! Crodo and I are eternally grateful. Let us review your fantastic campaign.
Okay, so this is the end of Clouds of Xeen. I'm gonna let the credits roll here, and once they are done, I'm gonna call it an episode. So thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time, wherein we start the dark side and things start getting real. Until then. Yeah.
Yeah!
Go now. Your destiny lies on the dark side.